from Central Food Technological Research Institute from Mysuru. I will be introducing all those. It's just to reaffirm that this program is being done by the NCERT in collaboration with CSIR's Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, New Delhi's headquarters, and PRABHAS, that is Pravasi Bharatiya Academic Sampark, Academic and Scientific Sampark, PRABHAS. So today is the third session, and the topic for today is, what does nutrition mean to us? We have already had two sessions on the similar, in the same series with Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni. We have got good feedback from our viewers. This program is telecasted on the PM eVidya channels directly, and also on NCERT's YouTube channel, as well as CSIR's YouTube handle, Facebook handle, and Twitter handle. All viewers can either write their questions on this YouTube channel at ciet.nic.in email. We'll take up all these questions either today or in subsequent sessions. So today I have with me Dr. Anand Mohit, who is the principal scientist at the CSIR New Delhi. He's sitting to my right, and to his right, this is Dr. Sunita Farakya, who is heading the Department of Education in Science and Mathematics at NCERT, and under whose guidance all this program is going on. I request Dr. Sunita Farakya to kindly introduce our speaker, Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni, who is joining us from Doha. Dr. Farakya, please.
Thanks for giving me the opportunity. Good morning and warm welcome to all our viewers. I am feeling great pleasure to introduce today's speaker, Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni, who will be speaking about what does nutrition mean to us. Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni has a PhD in molecular genetics from Ohio State University and master's degree in microbiology from Institute of Science, Mumbai. Her postdoctoral research focused on evolutionary genetics at the Institute of Molecular and Cell Biology, Singapore. This was followed by research target at elucidating the mechanism of breast cancer and cell biology, breast cancer at Weill Cornell Medicinal Center, Qatar. Dr. Rashmi is an entrepreneur in hydroponics as managing partner at Integrated Group Qatar. She is also an educator conducting outreach programs for students, parents, and teachers to familiarize everyone with the gut microbiome and how it relates to nutrition and long-term health. Dr. Rashmi is a volunteer for Global Indian Scientists and Technocrat Forum for the Ahar Kranti Nutritional Educational Module. So a round of applause for Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni. Dr. Rashmi ji, please.
Namaste everyone, and welcome to session 3 of this series. So we will be looking at what does nutrition mean to us. I would recommend hearing the previous session to relate it to this session, so it will be in continuation. I'm trying to keep it in continuation. So this session 3 will be focusing on the nutritional aspect. So hum nutrition ki baat karenge aaj. Pichli baar maine ye बताया था कि गट माइक्रोबायोम ये हमारा ये अलग ऑर्गन है जो बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट फंक्शन हमारे बॉडी में प्ले करता है. सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्गन दैट वी हैव इन आवर बॉडी दैट हैजंट बीन क्लासिफाइड एज एन ऑर्गन येट बट इट डज सो मेनी डिफरेंट थिंग्स फॉर अस एंड वन ऑफ देम इंक्लूड्स ट्रेनिंग आवर इम्यून सिस्टम. द अदर थिंग इज डाइजेस्टिंग एवरीथिंग दैट वी ईट and even the digesting the drugs that we take, the medications that we take. So these are some of the important functions that our gut microbiome does. So let's see how that relates to nutrition. That is not something I talked about in details in the previous session. So if we look at the gut here, we are looking at the gut here, and when the diet quality is poor, जब भोजन के हम जब कुपोषण होता है, there's a lot of animal derived protein, saturated fats, refined grains, there's a lot of sugar and carbohydrates in our diet, salt, alcohol, and artificial sweeteners. It is all of these are very poor in quality, and these are very harmful to the microorganisms that reside in our body, in our gut, and this causes a reduced microbial diversity. It is very important that we have a very high microbial diversity, as Anandji mentioned previously in the previous session, that the high diversity of these microorganisms provides us with the genes that are required to digest the food that we eat and to keep us healthy. They also help us in preventing infection. So when we have a poor quality diet, what happens is we have not only reduced diversity, but pathogen infection, inflammation, and all of these cause several chronic diseases. Here, in contrast, we are looking at a healthy diet where there are fruits, vegetables, high fiber diet, a plant-based proteins, and unsaturated fatty acids, mono and polyunsaturated fatty acids, which help us have a very high microbial diversity, and they really help us with keeping our health in very good shape. तो ये चीजें हमें देखनी चाहिए कि कुपोषण और सही बैलेंस्ड संतुलित आहार से क्या असर पड़ता है हमारे गट माइक्रोबायोम पे. अगर हम ये फूड पिरामिड देखें, सो दिस इज द रॉन्ग फूड पिरामिड. दिस इज व्हाट वी यूज्ड टू फॉलो सेवरल इयर्स अगो, वेयर कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स आर एट द बॉटम एंड फ्रूट्स वेजिटेबल्स आर अबव दैट. नाउ इट्स इन्वर्टेड. वी हैव अ रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ इंक्रीज्ड कंजम्पशन ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स एंड लेस कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स. बट लेट्स लुक एट द रॉन्ग फूड पिरामिड. अगर हम इस फूड पिरामिड को भी कंसिडर करें तो हमारे डाइट में आज क्या है. आवर डाइट्स आर वेरी कार्बोहाइड्रेट हैवी, विच एवर सोशो इकोनॉमिक क्लास वी लुक एट. एज आई मेंशन बिफोर, इट इज वेरी स्टार्च हैवी. देयर इज हार्डली एनी फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स, देयर आर हार्डली एनी सोर्सेज ऑफ विटामिंस एंड मिनरल्स. सो वी आर लुकिंग एट वेरी वेरी कार्बोहाइड्रेट हैवी डाइट्स थ्रू आउट ऑल स्ट्रेटा ऑफ सोशो इकोनॉमिक क्लासेस. तो ये कुपोषण की जो वजह है उससे क्या होता है. एंड इवन व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, लेट्स लुक एट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स वी आर ईटिंग. सो हाईलाइटेड हियर इन रेड, दीज आर द वंस दैट कॉज सीवियर हेल्थ इश्यूज फॉर अस. दीज आर ऑल दैट वी थिंक वी आर ईटिंग हेल्दी, बट दीज हैव रिफाइंड फ्लावर्स, दीज डू नॉट हैव द फाइबर दैट वी नीड इन ऑर्डर टू कीप अस हेल्दी. इंस्टेड व्हाट वी शुड बी ईटिंग आर ऑल ऑफ दीज, the unpolished rice, whole wheat or whole grain breads and pasta and things like that, everything that we make, even the roti that we eat, everything that we need to eat should be high fiber and not made from refined flour like we tend to chew. So why is that important? Because when we are looking at whole grains, this is the fiber that we really need for good health. And this is the germ of any whole grain, which has all the nutrients packed in it, which has all the vitamins, minerals, healthy fats. When this is refined, all of this is stripped. So all we have is carbohydrates, which are basically sugars. तो हम जब refined grains खाते हैं तो हमें ये मिलता है, हमें कोई fiber या कोई nutrients मिलते नहीं हैं दूसरे. And what does that do? When we are looking at consumption of fiber, fibers, the foods that are low in fiber, when we consume those, they cause rapid assimilation of glucose. So, वो बहुत ही जल्दी digest होते हैं और उससे glucose बहुत जल्दी release होता है ऐसे low fiber food से, और बहुत जल्दी glucose बढ़ता भी है, blood sugar बढ़ता है उससे. And if we are talking about foods that are high in dietary fiber, that are healthy, what they do is they absorb water, they form a gel, and this slows down digestion of the foods that we eat. This slows down absorption of the sugars and even the fats. And this increase in viscosity, it increases the viscosity of the food in our stomach, and then it slows down the release of blood glucose. So jo diet high fiber hota hai wo blood sugar bahut hi dheere bahut hi healthy tarike se increase karta hai. So if we look at the traditional foods, which have a wide range of foods, that's what our body really needs. That we need different sources of vitamins, minerals, fiber, and everything that our body requires. If we do that, which is present in a traditional diet, our intestinal cells that we looked at in the previous presentation have a healthy layer of mucus. They have a healthy coating of microorganisms on them, and this is a healthy state. But in contrast, if we look at what we are really eating, Lancet Commission ne dikhaya tha 2019 mein ki Asian diet jo hota hai, that is very starch heavy. It has very less of the other constituents that are required. तो इससे क्या होता है, ये स्टार्च हैवी डाइट जो हम आजकल खाते हैं, वी थिंक वी आर ईटिंग हेल्दी बट मेजॉरिटी ऑफ व्हाट वी ईट इज कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स और स्टार्च. सो व्हाट दैट डज, एज आई मेंशन बिफोर, इफ वी रिलेटेड टू फूड नाउ, इज दैट इट इज कॉजिंग अ वेरी लो डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. इट इज कॉजिंग हार्म टू आर म्यूकस लेयर एंड अ लीकी गट. सो दीज आर वेरी कॉमन रीजन्स ऑफ मेनी ऑफ द क्रॉनिक डिसीजेस. If we consider how we eat fruits and vegetables, people think of eating overcooked or fried vegetables as probably healthy, or fruit juices as healthy. But what we should be eating is minimally cooked, probably stir-fried vegetables, fruits in a raw form. And the reason for that is when we eat a fruit, so this is an example, the amount of sugar that we get from a fruit is this. For example, if we consider an orange, and we get a lot of fiber from it, which slows down the release of the sugar. Instead, if we choose fruit juice, so this one glass probably contains four oranges. We have four times the amount of sugar. This is much more than the daily recommendation of the entire day for an adult. And we are not even getting most of the fiber in it. What it's causing is a rapid rise in blood sugar. And the same with orange soda. And diet soda is, although it doesn't have sugar directly, it has artificial sweeteners, which cause even more damage to the microbiome. It alters how our body reacts to sugar. So, ये चीजें हमें consider करनी चाहिए जब हम choose करते हैं कि fruits हम कैसे खाते हैं, fruits, fruit juice या soda. It's very important that we focus on this and we know what we are choosing. Even when we look at how we consume dairy and fish, so these are the different things in the food pyramid I'm going through. So we are looking at consuming artificial products and fried probably fish, whereas we should be looking at much more natural alternatives and healthier ways of cooking. So one example I would like to give when we are looking at dairy products, these are examples. This is a label from a very so-called healthy yogurt brand. Yogurt drink. So if we look at the added sugars, it is 18% of our daily recommended limit. And if we look at this low fat yogurt, it's a very small serving, single serving. Although it is low fat, what is important to note here is it has 21 grams of sugar. And the daily recommended percentage is not even mentioned because it's too high. And what does all of this do? So again, let's look at meat products. We are looking at fried or very processed meat products that people are consuming. There are much healthier ways of cooking these meat products. So, hum sari cheeze jo khate hain, usse jo process karte hain, that is extremely important. Ki hum consider karein ki hum sochte hain hum healthy kha rahe hain, but wo kaise process hote hain. So, I will talk in greater details about this processing in my next presentation. But what is important to note is if we look at each class or each step of the pyramid, we are making the wrong choices. Agar hum sugars or fats ki baat karein, to sugars hum in cheezon se hume milti hai. Jo healthy cheeze hoti hai, unse nahi. Hum candies or cakes or pastries se sugars ke sources dhoondte hain, or fried foods and a lot of healthy oils which has trans fat or saturated fats. Instead, we should be looking at healthier sources of sugar. Probably ones that also have fiber. The dates are a very good example for that. There are very healthy oils in nuts, seeds, and we should also be looking at consuming oils that have unsaturated fatty acids, which are really healthy for us. So again, if we go back to sugar, what's wrong with eating sugar? Your sugar addiction hota hai, that is so serious that it is even more addictive than cocaine. What happens when we eat sugar is there's a rapid spike in blood sugar levels because sugar digest bahut easily hoti hai, there's no fiber in it. Aur jab ye digest hoti hai, to dopamine is released in the brain, and it immediately signals that, oh, this is making me very happy. And it is a lot of insulin is secreted. And after that, what happens is, because the blood, the sugar is digested so fast, it falls equally rapidly. जितनी जल्दी ऊपर जाता है ब्लड शुगर उतनी ही जल्दी नीचे आता है और उस क्रैश की वजह से हम और ज्यादा शुगर क्रेव करने लगते हैं. वी स्टार्ट क्रेविंग इट मोर एंड मोर एंड दिस साइकिल कीप्स गोइंग. यू ईट शुगर, यू कीप वांटिंग इट मोर एंड मोर और ये एडिक्शन चलता रहता है शुगर का. और शुगर, व्हेन आई से शुगर, इट्स नॉट जस्ट द शुगर एज वी नो. देर आर सेवरल हिडन नेम्स ऑफ शुगर. ऑल ऑफ दीज आर different forms of sugar. There are artificial sweeteners that people think are healthy. Many of the diabetics eat artificial sweeteners instead of sugar, and they are not really healthy. They are damaging the gut microbiome to a great extent. So, hum jab dekhte hain ki hum kitna sugar consume kar rahe hain, so we need to consider all of these as well. There might be many more. So, what happens with sugar? This is just a diagram showing how sugar is metabolized in our body. इसमें important चीज ये है कि जब हम sugar या carbohydrates या कोई भी source खाते हैं जिससे sugar मिलती है, जो glucose is basically sugar, what happens is it is converted to cholesterol and fat. So cholesterol and fat doesn't necessarily come from the fat that we eat. It comes from the sugar that we eat, and most people do not consider this fact while consuming sugar sources so easily. तो हम जब carbohydrates खाते हैं, जो pastries और cakes और pizzas और burgers, everything that is very high in calories, very high in empty calories, इसमें कोई nutrients नहीं होते, तो उससे क्या होता है? Directly उसका conversion cholesterol और fat में होता है, because our body does not need that many calories. It needs lot fewer calories. We need more nutrients and not these calories. So we are actually damaging our bodies by eating more and more carbohydrates without knowing what it's doing. तो हम ये देखते हैं कि calories क्या है. हम हमेशा जो diets होते हैं, काफी सारे diets हैं, वो recommend करते हैं. So without really going through all of this, मैं ये कहना चाहती हूँ कि हमें calories के recommendations होते हैं that males at this age should be eating whatever number of calories, 1200, or females at this age should be eating 2200 calories. But what does all this mean? We are only focusing on calories here. When we burn garbage, we can still get calories. कूड़ा जलाने से भी calories मिलती है. क्या हम हमारे भोजन में ऐसी चीजें डालेंगे जिससे हमें केवल कैलोरीज मिले? बिकॉज व्हाट वी नीड इज रियली कैलोरीज फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सोर्सेस. वी नीड कैलोरीज फ्रॉम कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स. देयर इज अ रिकमेंडेड लिमिट फ्रॉम व्हाट वी शुड गेट फ्रॉम कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, फ्रॉम फैट्स, फ्रॉम प्रोटीन्स. एंड वी नीड वेरी स्पेसिफिक सोर्सेस ऑफ दीज कैलोरीज. वी कैनॉट बी सो जनरल अबाउट जस्ट गेटिंग कैलोरीज. सो देयर इज अ टर्मिनोलॉजी इन कंप्यूटर साइंस वेरी कॉमनली यूज्ड, where they say that garbage in is equal to garbage out. जो हमारा input होता है, output भी वैसे ही होता है. If we put things in our stomach that are absolutely not worth eating, that are not providing the right nutrients for our body to function properly, it is going to cause a lot of damage to not only our brains but to our entire body, and this will be directly proportional to what we eat. So this is something that we really need to consider. What we are putting in our bodies is exactly the output that we are going to get. That's why we have to be even more careful in selecting the food that we are eating. So just for a short break in between, I would like to recommend a 2-week experiment. So this experiment actually is very short. So hum agar ye kare ki hum hame jo junk food pasand hai, तो अब लास्ट सेशन 2 हफ्ते बाद होगा, इसीलिए मैं ये सजेस्ट कर रही हूँ दैट कोई भी साइंटिस्ट जब एक्सपेरिमेंट करता है तो देयर इज वन एक्सपेरिमेंटल कंडीशन, देयर इज अ पॉजिटिव कंट्रोल विच वी डेफिनेटली नो विल वर्क, एंड देयर इज ऑल्सो अ नेगेटिव कंट्रोल विच वी नो शुड नॉट वर्क. सो दिस इज हाउ एक्सपेरिमेंट्स आर नॉर्मली डन. तो आपको जो भी जंक फूड पसंद हो, बर्गर हो या पिज्जा का स्लाइस हो या एनीथिंग दैट यू लाइक, यू कैन टेक दैट एंड लीव इट as it is on a counter probably for 2 weeks. And then, as a positive control, you can take something that is homemade or some kind of street food, which is equivalent, which we know will definitely get spoiled within much before the 2 week time period is over. And as a negative control, something that is non-living or made of plastic probably, that we know is not going to get spoiled. So what we want to see here is, will this get spoiled? Will this be decomposed by any microorganisms? So this is the experiment. I will talk about it in more details in the next session and in the last session as well. So this is something that we all should do to figure out what exactly we are putting in our bodies. So moving on to a different aspect, मैंने अभी तक जो बात की वो हम कैसे चूज करते हैं, हम क्या खा रहे हैं, हम कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स के बारे में क्या सोचते हैं, फ्रूट्स, वेजिटेबल्स, फैट्स, ये सब हम सोचते हैं हम हेल्दी खा रहे हैं, बट वॉट आर वी एक्चुअली ईटिंग. सो नाउ वी विल फोकस ऑन हु कंट्रोल्स वॉट वी ईट. वी गेट ऑल द एजुकेशन दैट वी नीड टू मेक ऑल ऑफ दीज वंडरफुल चॉइसेस इन आवर लाइफ, बट डू वी रियली हैव द कंट्रोल ऑन वॉट वी ईट. So one important factor in who controls what we eat are our gut microorganisms. So as I've written here, no one dines alone. हम जो भी खाते हैं उसके जो cravings होते हैं वो हमारे सिर्फ हमारे नहीं होते हैं. All of these microorganisms are also making us crave that. And this is the history that we have built up over our life. ये जो collection हमने बनाया है ये lifetime पे होता है, हमारे birth से होता है. और हमने जितना हेल्दी कलेक्शन बनाया है उतने हेल्दी क्रेविंग्स होंगे, जितना अनहेल्दी कलेक्शन है उतने अनहेल्दी क्रेविंग्स होंगे. सो दिस इज वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर दैट द गट माइक्रोब्स आल्सो मेक अस क्रेव फॉर ऑल ऑफ दिस अनहेल्दी फूड्स इफ दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव बीन ईटिंग फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम. द अदर फैक्टर इज एक्सटर्नल इन्फ्लुएंसेस. इफ वी लुक एट द कॉन्स्टेंट बम्बार्डमेंट ऑफ कमर्शियल्स ऑफ अनहेल्दी फूड, we have all of these external influences. It doesn't matter how much knowledge we have, we are constantly seeing all of these unhealthy things on all kinds of media, on TV, on YouTube, everywhere that we look at, on social media. So ye sare external factors mein se ek hai jo influence karta hai hamare food choices ko. Then there's distracted eating. So when we are eating, why is that important? हम जब खाना खाते हैं, हम कुछ भी खाते हैं, ब्रेकफास्ट खाते हैं, सो दिस इज अ कॉमन थीम दैट वी आर लुकिंग एट. एवरीबडी दीज डेज ईट्स लाइक दिस. दे आर ईदर ऑन द फोन और लुकिंग वॉचिंग सम प्रॉबली सीरियल और टीवी शो टुगेदर विद द फैमिली एंड दे थिंक इट्स फैमिली टाइम, बट एवरीबडी इज एक्चुअली लुकिंग एट द टीवी. एंड वॉट हैपन्स विद दिस इज हम जब डिस्ट्रैक्ट होते हैं तो हमें ये पता नहीं चलता कि हम क्या खा रहे हैं. वॉट आर वी एक्चुअली ईटिंग? There is no connection between what we are doing and the food. How much are we eating? Because we are so distracted, even if we are trying to eat healthy, we have no idea about what we are. We keep eating. Probably we eat too much, or we eat very less, or we eat a very unbalanced diet. So, हमें पता ही नहीं चलता हम कितना और क्या खा रहे हैं. One a very important thing is what time are we eating? हम किस समय पे खा रहे हैं? कि हम शोज जब होते हैं तब खा रहे हैं या हमें जब वक्त होता है तब खा रहे हैं. सो द टाइमिंग इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट. वी आर नॉट एट ऑल फॉलोइंग द सर्काडियन रिदम दीज डेज. सो दैट दिस इज व्हाट आई मीन बाय डिस्ट्रैक्टेड ईटिंग. द अदर फैक्टर इज चिल्ड्रेन आर वॉचिंग अ लॉट ऑफ कॉन्टेंट ऑन सोशल मीडिया, ऑन यूट्यूब. और जो यंग इन्फ्लुएंसर्स होते हैं, जो खुद बच्चे होते हैं, जो ऐसे वीडियोज बनाते हैं आजकल, there are a lot of commercials or advertisements of that are marketing junk food. So parents need to be aware of this, that the videos that your children are watching have content that is marketing junk food. So these are some of the things that are highly influencing our food choices. So if we think about why the children like junk food, this could be one of the reasons they are having so much exposure. Another thing we are looking at is the cereal box psychology, as mentioned by a Cornell University researcher. So what this does is, the grocery stores normally place things that children would definitely like to eat, and it can be very unhealthy. So these things are placed strategically in places where children can easily see it. बच्चों को जो सीधी तरह से इजीली दिखाई दे ऐसी जगह रखी जाती है ऐसी चीजें, और काफी बार वो बहुत अनहेल्दी होती है. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेज इन विच चिल्ड्रेन आर सिलेक्टिंग मेकिंग ऑल ऑफ दीज चॉइसेस. एंड देन देयर्स दिस थिंग ऑफ 24/7, एवरीथिंग इज ओपन 24/7, एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल 24/7. जब 24/7 सब अवेलेबल होता है तो इज योर बॉडी अवेलेबल फॉर डाइजेस्टिंग ऑल ऑफ दिस 24/7? नो, इट्स नॉट. सो एक और चीज मैं कहना चाहती हूँ, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस इज द मिसलीडिंग लेबल्स दैट वी आर लुकिंग एट. सो आर द फूड लेबल्स ट्रिकिंग यू? वेन वी आर लुकिंग एट फूड लेबल्स, आई वॉन्ट टू गिव एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ स्प्रेड दैट इज वेरी वेरी लव्ड बाय मोस्ट चिल्ड्रेन. एंड इफ वी लुक एट how misleading it is, it's an example of a tasty yet balanced breakfast, and yet the first ingredient in this is sugar. If you look at the amount of sugar it has, it's scary, and this is labeled as a healthy balanced breakfast. So when people are choosing things like this, I would very strongly urge people to read labels and to see what they are actually selecting. तो हमें लेबल्स पढ़ के बहुत ही जरूरी है देखना कि हम एक्चुअली क्या खा रहे हैं. अनदर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस इज द फ्रूट पंच फ्लेवर्ड ड्रिंक. सो इट लुक्स लाइक फ्रूट जूस, बट अगर हम इंग्रेडिएंट्स देखेंगे तो इसमें फ्रूट जूस के जैसा कुछ भी नहीं है. इट्स ऑल केमिकल, इट हैज लेस देन 5% जूस, एंड दिस इज फ्रॉम अ वेरी पॉपुलर सॉफ्ट ड्रिंक विच इज लेबल्ड एज जीरो कैलोरी. बट वॉट इट डज इज इट हैज आर्टिफिशियल स्वीटनर्स, it has preservatives. So even though it doesn't have calories, it is actually doing something very harmful to our bodies. So hum ye bahut hi zaruri hai ki hum jab nutrition ke bare mein sochte hain, hum itna sara us pe samay bitate hain. So we should be very careful at reading food labels and getting the right information about what we are eating. And this is something that I want to mention, that we wear smartwatches and we are so conscious of our health, but our body is constantly providing real-time indicators of our health, and these are free indicators. हमारा शरीर हमें बार बार बताता रहता है हर रोज हर दिन कि हमारे शरीर में क्या कमियां हैं. There is something deficient, we are dehydrated, there is something wrong, we are stressed, and these are just a few indicators that I have shown here. There are many, many more free indicators that our body is constantly giving us. कि न्यूट्रिशन में कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, कुछ कमियां हैं, कुछ मिल नहीं रहा है, कुछ ज्यादा हो रहा है, स्ट्रेस ज्यादा हो रहा है. वी हैव ऑल ऑफ दीज इंडिकेटर्स ऑल द टाइम, एंड वी शुड बी फोकसिंग ऑन दीज, वी शुड बी लुकिंग एट दीज वेरी केयरफुली. सो अगर हम ऑक्सीजन की बात करें, ऑक्सीजन वी एज वी नो इट्स इसेंशियल फॉर आवर लाइफ. वी आर लुकिंग एट, वी ब्रीद ऑक्सीजन एवरी डे. And there is no other replacement for that. We know it's essential, and that's all we breathe. We never replace the oxygen that we breathe with anything else. So, hum jab hamare ek essential cheez ko replace nahi karte, so why do we replace the nutrients and the water that our body needs with other chemicals so easily? Because ye bhi hamare sharir ki requirement hai, aur ye bhi hamare sharir ki requirement hai. Ye dono cheezein हमारे बॉडी को स्मूथली काम करने में मदद करती है. इफ़ वी डोंट हैव ऑक्सीजन वी विल डाई वेरी सून, बट इफ वी डोंट हैव न्यूट्रिएंट्स इट विल बी अ वेरी स्लो पेनफुल काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग विथ मेनी क्रॉनिक डिसीजेस. सो इफ वी लुक एट प्योर न्यूट्रिएंट्स, दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ प्योर वाटर. व्हेन वी हैव H2O वी हैव प्योर वाटर. तो अभी जो स्टूडेंट्स जो केमिस्ट्री सीख रहे हैं उनको आइडिया होगा कि मैं क्या बात कर रही हूँ. So when we look at pure nutrients, we get something pure out of it. We get a good healthy body. Here we are looking at only H2O, we are getting only water. But if we pollute it, if we add something else that is not desirable, for example salt in water, will we be able to drink it? It will cause more harm than good. So just like this reaction, if we look at all of these chemical reactions that are happening in our body, हमारे शरीर में ये जो बहुत सारी chemical reactions पे हमारी body चलती है, सारे cells में जो chemical reactions होते रहते हैं, millions of chemical reactions all the time, उन chemical reactions के लिए भी specific reagents की जरूरत होती है. और वो reagents क्या है? हमारे बॉडी के जो केमिकल रिएक्शन है, वी शुड सपोर्ट ऑल ऑफ दीज केमिकल रिएक्शंस विद द रिएजेंट्स दैट आवर बॉडी नीड्स. और ये नॉलेज हमारे पास है. वी नीड मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स, वी नीड कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, वी नीड हेल्दी फैट्स, वी नीड फाइबर विच इज ऑल्सो अ पार्ट ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, वी नीड प्रोटीन्स. सो दीज आर जस्ट नॉट जस्ट स्ट्रक्चरल बट ऑल्सो फंक्शनल. वी नीड माइक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड ट्रेस मिनरल्स. So these are vitamins, minerals, and trace elements. All of these are the reagents that support the chemical reactions that are going on in our bodies. If we miss out on any of these, the chemical reactions are not going to happen in the right manner. So this is something we really need to focus on when we choose our diet. हम हमारे डाइट को इतना लाइटली लेते हैं और जब हम जंक फूड खाते हैं तो हमें जो कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स मिलते हैं जो डायरेक्टली कोलेस्टेरॉल और फैट में कन्वर्ट होता है और हमें पता ही नहीं चलता कि मैं तो हेल्दी खा रहा था, मैंने तो आई हैड नॉट ईटन एनी फैट. सो हाउ डिड दिस हैपन? हाउ डिड ऑल द क्रॉनिक डिसीजेस हैपन? दिस इज व्हाई ऑल ऑफ इट इज हैपनिंग, बिकॉज आवर बॉडी इज गिविंग अस इंडिकेशंस ऑल द टाइम एंड वी आर नॉट लुकिंग एट एनी ऑफ दोज. सो वी शुड रियली सपोर्ट ऑल ऑफ दीज केमिकल रिएक्शंस. Additionally, एक और चीज मैं कहना चाहती हूँ importantly, that the spices that we use in Indian cuisine are extremely beneficial for our health. So this is not mentioned in the nutrients that we require, but these are very beneficial for the gut microbiome. So when we are consuming different spices, especially the complex combination of spices that we have in our cuisine, what this does is it supports the gut microbiome, it supports immunity. So there are many metabolites secreted by the microbiome that help our long-term health by consuming spices. So these are very overlooked and these are also missing in the junk food, the Western diet that we are consuming nowadays. So this is another consideration that we should give. So with this, I would like to end the talk, but I just want to mention one aspect that I heard from the feedback that I received. I'll just spend 1 minute on it. So I had a question about what Helicobacter pylori does. So it is a bacteria that is known to cause harmful effects on our health. So ye jo H. pylori infection hota hai, that can cause even gastric cancers. It can cause different kinds of gastric ulcers. It can cause changes in the microbiome itself, and it is linked to different forms of gastric cancers. So ye jo Helicobacter hai uske bare mein feedback tha. So it is exacerbated by unhealthy diet, absolutely. And what it does, it causes different forms of gastric cancer, as we can see here. But current research is showing that it may also have a beneficial effect. तो एच पाइलोरी के जो इन्फेक्शन होते हैं वो एंटीबायोटिक से लोग क्लियर करने की कोशिश करते हैं कि उससे और कोई ये ना प्रॉब्लम्स ना हो. बट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग नाउ इज इट इज बीइंग रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एज बीइंग बेनिफिशियल एज वेल. जिन पॉपुलेशंस में एच पाइलोरी कम हो चुका है, ऑल्दो ये बहुत हार्मफुल है, बट जिन पॉपुलेशन में ये कम हो चुका है वहाँ पे दूसरे डिसीजेस का बहुत ही इंक्रीज हो रहा है, लाइक अस्थमा और डायरियल डिसीजेस or GERD or Barrett's esophagus. So these are some of the diseases that have been linked to a decline of H. pylori. So it is very important to balance our microbiome. I will be talking more about that, how to balance it, but I just wanted to mention it. So I'll stop sharing now.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni. It was indeed a nice listening to you. Yes, many of the questions which we had in our mind have been answered, but that has resulted into more number of questions in our mind. I have got some questions through our YouTube handle, which I will be asking you a little later. But in the meantime, we have with us a team from Central Food Technological Research Institute, Mysuru, who works on the similar lines here in this country, in India. So today, this team is being represented by Dr. Jyoti Lakshmi, who is the principal scientist there. May I request Dr. Jyoti to kindly inform the audience about the kind of effects, the kind of initiatives which are being taken, research initiatives which are being taken in this country in the same directions. And I believe that at Mysuru, we have some parents with us who would like to interact with the speaker, Dr. Rashmi ji. So over to CFTRI, Dr. Jyoti, please.
Namaskar. Good morning, everybody. I would like to thank Prabhas and NCRT for giving me this opportunity to be part of this program. I also thank Dr. Rashmi for enlightening our audience, that is the children, school children and their parents, about different food groups, the nutrients they provide, and the quality and quantity of the nutrients that needs to be consumed by the children. Here I have to mention one more point, that the program is very aptly targeted for 9 to 12 class children who belong to the adolescent group, that is 12 to 18 years of age. This age group comprises of nearly 1/5 of the total population, and the word adolescence is derived from the Greek word which means growth and maturity. So these children are in their active stage of growth, and any health and nutritional knowledge imparted to these children will be very well implemented, and this is how we can get a good healthy population for the future. The period of adolescence is the transition period between childhood and adulthood. This is the second highest period of growth in human life, next to infancy. The adolescents nearly gain 30% of their adult weight and 20% of their adult height during this period. So their nutritional requirements are really high, and they have to be guided upon for choosing healthy and nutritional diets. The period is very crucial, since these are the formative years of life of an individual, where major physical, biological, and hormonal changes occur, leading to psychosocial, behavioral changes, and sexual maturation. Dr. Rashmi also highlighted on the diversity of the diet that exists between the urban and rural areas and their influence on the health and nutritional status of the children. This is very well reflected in the double burden of malnutrition. In the lower economic strata, we find a chronic energy deficiency, protein energy deficiency, then iron deficiency anemia, while in the higher strata, we find obesity, overweight, and related problems. To meet the high growth rate and developmental needs, these children require very high nutrient content per unit body weight. Their nutritional requirements are almost equivalent to that of the adults. Some of the classic nutritional studies that have been conducted in our country has shown that unless proper nourishment is provided, it's not possible to attain growth to the full genetic potential. Though the children has genetic propensity to gain proper height and weight, if proper nourishment is not provided, then they will fail to reach the full genetic potential. In addition to growth and development, the present day adolescents are also exposed to challenges like high competitiveness in schools, and those involved in sports require much more additional nutrients. And in the low socioeconomic strata, adolescent girls also face additional responsibilities of performing the household chores, childbearing, and other family responsibilities. The current nutrition Indian scenario indicate that nearly 30% of the children are underweight and stunted, that is, they have low weight for their height and age. And another 10% of the children are moving towards overweight or obesity over the last decade. Iron deficiency anemia is another nutritional problem which is highly persistently occurring in the school children because of their poor eating habits. Inadequate nutrition in adolescents can potentially retard growth and sexual maturation. Their lifestyle and eating behaviors, along with underlying socio-psychological factors, and are particularly important threats to adequate nutrition. In the elite class, adolescents are reported to consume more of high fat and sugar foods, which usually lack most of the essential micronutrients. The low intake of iron and calcium among adolescent girls is really a cause of concern. Iron deficiency anemia, apart from affecting the physical growth, is also known to affect their cognitive abilities. And some of the intervention studies we have conducted, we found that after giving the iron supplements to the children, their school performance improved like anything, and their school attendance also improved at the same time. Eating healthy diet is associated with improved memory and better performance at school. Micronutrient supplementation to children have showed improved scholastic performance, mood improvement, and reduced absenteeism. Coming to the fruit and vegetable choices of the children, in one of the school lunch programs, when we visited to evaluate the midday meal program, which has been hosted by our governments, we found that children were just removing the vegetables from their plates and discarding. When they were asked about it, they expressed their dislike towards it. When the parents were interviewed about their dietary habits, they said this is a challenging task even at the household levels. So our institute made some efforts to formulate food products incorporating vegetables so that we can be sure that these vegetables consumption of the children. We tried incorporating the vegetables, especially green leafy vegetables, which are the treasure house of nutrients and nutraceuticals, into the conventional food recipes like breads, chapati, or khakra, and even porridges. And this was possible at 5 to 10% level in terms of dehydrated vegetables, which is equal to almost 50 to 100 gram of the fresh vegetables. Though we know that some of the nutrients are lost during processing, but still we can make sure some part of the nutrients at least reaches the children. With the advice of our Honorable Prime Minister, our institute also was successful in adding fresh fruit juice into the carbonated beverages as a source of micronutrient enrichment and value addition. We do have many fruit bars, jams, and jellies, which are concentrated source of micronutrients, and these were provided as part of school intervention programs, and they were very well accepted by the children, and this also led to improvement in their vitamin A status. Children of this age are usually open to new ideas. They show curiosity and interest. So if this age group is sensitized about the significance of good nutrition, it will impact on their current nutritional status and growth. And this will also lay a healthy foundation for their future life. In one of our intervention studies, we provided iron supplements to different age group people in the community. And we found that children showed maximum compliance. So they can serve as good messengers for transmitting the good health and nutrition practices for their family, peers, and siblings as well. Considering these factors, our government has implemented Kishori Yojana under the current ICDS program. And one of the major objectives of this program is to improve the health and nutritional status of the adolescent group. Under this program, under the National Health Mission, they are also providing iron and folate tablets to the children on a weekly basis, and this also has shown good compliance. Practicing good dietary habits is also known to improve the gut microbiome in addition to improving the nutritional status and overall development. Thank you. Now I would invite our audience.
Just a second, Jyoti ji, you have given a very useful and great presentation indeed. Thank you very much. In fact, you have already answered many of the questions which you are receiving through our YouTube handle. And thank you very much for such a beautiful and useful presentation, Dr. Jyoti. Now I request you to kindly coordinate the task of questions from the parents, those who are CFTRI, please. We have got few parents here in NCRT studios also. So they will also be asking the questions towards a point where the CFTRI parents leaves the discussion. Thank you. Please.
Okay.
Please carry
now
on.
Now I invite upon Mr. Pawan to ask his question with Dr. Rashmi.
Good morning, ma'am. Mera naam Pawan Kumar hai. Mera aapse ye sawal tha. It is difficult to explain children to eat healthy, nutritious food. How can we change their eating habits?
Okay, it's a very relevant question and the problem that everybody has, that when we want our children to eat healthy, I would like to ask the parent, what are they eating? Are you eating healthy food yourself? So if the answer is no, it is unlikely that the children will eat healthy food. So that's the first point. The other point is introducing healthy food in very interesting ways in which the children can be involved in preparing it and they feel even decorating it, plating it in ways that look very fancy, because you know children are very much into social media. They think that food should be looking cool looking as well. So parents can do many of these things to get their children involved in making healthy food, and we can make it even more colorful by including fruits and vegetables, and even get more micronutrients by doing that. So these are just some of the things that can help make the children eat healthy food. So I will talk more about that in the subsequent sessions. So I hope that helps for now.
Thank you, ma'am.
Namaste, ma'am. I am Nivedita. माई क्वेश्चन इज आजकल के लाइफ स्टाइल में ड्यू टू लैक ऑफ टाइम और अदरवाइज हमें प्रोसेस फूड्स खरीदना बहुत ही कन्वीनियंट लगता है. सो वॉट कैन वी डू अबाउट दिस?
ओके, दैट इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. सो वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रोसेस फूड्स, आई विल कवर दैट इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. बट वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रोसेस्ड फूड्स, नॉट ऑल प्रोसेस्ड फूड्स आर बैड, नॉट ऑल पैकेज्ड फूड्स आर बैड, बट वी रियली नीड टू स्टार्ट रीडिंग द लेबल्स. Because that will tell us what exactly are we eating, does it have any preservatives, how long is it stored, will it help us. If we look at frozen food, for example, there are frozen vegetables. If we look at, we don't have time to, you know, process the vegetables, cut those. So there are enough resources for that. So that is packaged. There are some very healthy options in packaged foods as well. So yes, I agree that it is very difficult to make everything on your own. But we can definitely start reading labels. That would be the first starting point to choose between healthy and unhealthy packaged food. So,
thank you.
Yes.
Good morning, madam. My name is Anbar. I have a question.
Yes.
We think we are eating nutritious food, but how do we know if we are eating healthy?
Okay, yes. So the very interesting point that you raised, that everybody that I talk to tends to think that they are eating very healthy. But when we actually look at the diet, it's very unbalanced. So it's kind of like you're taking attendance in your plate. So is the fat present? Is the vegetable present? Is the carbohydrate present? We are not looking at the proportions that we need to eat, that our plate should be half full of fruits and vegetables, 1/4 carbohydrates, 1/4 protein, whatever the recommendation is. I'm not a nutritionist. बट जब हम डाइट के बारे में सोचते हैं, वी थिंक वी आर ईटिंग हेल्दी फूड. द फूड इटसेल्फ इज हेल्दी, बट इज इट इन द राइट प्रपोर्शन? इज इट एट द राइट टाइम ऑफ द डे? सो देर आर मेनी मेनी कंसिडरेशंस. आर वी सिटिंग डाउन एंड फोकसिंग ऑन वॉट वी ईट? सो दैट विल टेल अस. एंड आवर बॉडी इज गिविंग मेनी इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ हाउ वी एक्चुअली फील. कि हमें थकान महसूस हो रही है, आर वी टायर्ड, आर वी नॉट स्लीपिंग वेल, इज समथिंग हैपनिंग विद अस, इज आर हेयर फॉलिंग, तो इन चीजों से हमें पता चल सकता है कि हम एक्चुअली हेल्दी खा रहे हैं या नहीं. तो
थैंक यू,
दैट आंसर्स एट लीस्ट पार्टली.
Hello, Dr. Rashmi. My name is Aishwarya.
Hello.
My question is, आपने कहा कि distracted eating जो है वो हमारी सेहत के लिए सही नहीं है. अगर हम nutritious खाना खा रहे हैं उसके बावजूद वो कैसे खराब है?
Very, very relevant question, because everybody that we look at, including myself, I am guilty of doing that. We are always eating with either the phone in our hand or something else. We are not focused on what we are eating. So what happens is we are not chewing the food properly. We are swallowing it without chewing. There are so many different things that we are doing with the food. So the bolus is not formed. We are not balancing it the way we think we should. So intention is right that humne khana bahut nutritious banaya hai, sab kuch ingredients fresh laya hai, everything is right. But the actual act of eating is distracted. So hum kitna kha rahe hain, kya kha rahe hain, we are not interacting with the food that that is very important. To uski jo prakriya hoti hai body mein wo normally nahi ho rahi hai, even though it's nutritious. Aur hamara khana bhi, because it's distracted eating, it is according to the timing of maybe TV shows or something like that. It is not according to the time of the day or the circadian rhythm. Wo hamare body ke sync mein nahi hai, wo TV pe jo shows hai uske sync mein hai. So that is something that is causing great harm, even though we think we are eating nutritious food. That's why we might not get the nutrients, even though we are eating healthy food.
Thank you.
Madam, good morning, madam.
Good morning.
Satish, madam. Madam, we see children are eating more junk foods than
yes.
traditional food.
Yes.
How can change that, madam?
Okay, so very relevant question. So. Children are eating junk food because we are introducing them to junk food, firstly. If we never introduce them, they won't even know unless they try something out. So one example I want to give, in my daughter's school, when she was the first day of kindergarten, they had people distributing balloons from a fast food joint. It is an international fast food joint, I don't want to name it, but they had those distributing balloons. And that was something that was absolutely, I mean, if schools start doing this, advertising junk food to children who are new in the school, that is something very disturbing. So jo exposure hai wo hame kam karna chahiye, aur jo traditional foods hai, they are also equally interesting. I mean, they are much better actually. If we look at even the street food, main hamesha sev puri ka example deti hu, that it's so tasty and it can contain a lot of micro macronutrients, vegetables, it can have, you know, tomatoes, onions, potatoes, everything fresh except the sev and the puri. So you can replace the junk food very slowly with things like this that are much tastier, that the children will actually start craving, and that will provide them with the actual nutrients that they need. So aise cheezon se agar dheere dheere replace karenge, ye मतलब अचानक नहीं हो सकता, बट दिस हैज टू बी ग्रेजुअल, दैट इट कैन बी डन.
सो थैंक यू डॉक्टर जयति लक्ष्मी. इट्स एन इंडीड टास्क फ्रॉम सीएफटीआरआई टुडे. आई वंस अगेन आई ऑन रिकॉर्ड थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग सच ए ब्यूटीफुल प्रेजेंटेशन टुगेदर विद डॉक्टर रश्मि कुलकर्णी. नाउ वी हैव few parents at our NCRT studio. I am calling one of them for her question to Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni. Please, may I ask my team to? Yes. Pooja ji, first you introduce yourself. Just tell us about you and then please
Hello.
Ask your question.
Hello, Doctor. I'm Pooja Banerjee. I'm a mother of two. I just want to ask one thing, that it is natural to have look-alike qualities and tendencies in siblings. But how is it possible that over the years when husband and wives, they are living together, and after a few years, they start looking alike brothers and sisters?
Very interesting. With the, they are coming from the different genes. They are coming from the
different they genes. Are coming, though they are coming from different biometer, but still they look alike. How is it possible, ma'am?
Very, very interesting question, and that is something that I always used to think about as a child, that how come two very different individuals from different families are like looking so alike. So one explanation for that is, as I mentioned previously in my previous presentation, that our DNAs are 99.9% identical. So that is not what makes us different. What makes us different is, one of the factors that makes us different is our gut microbiome, or the microorganisms that help us digest and metabolize food. So when a couple is living in the same environment, husband, wife, the same environment mein reh rahe, same microorganisms ko exposed hai, same khana kha rahe hai, probably. So they start looking alike, I think, probably because that's a reaction to their microorganisms. That is what makes people different, but now they are in an environment which is most similar. That's why they start even taking decisions that are similar. Because what we eat and how it is processed in our body helps us choose everything in our life. So, similar dikhte nahi, even decisions jo lete hain couples, wo bhi similar hote hain, and that could be one of the explanations. That is our gut microbiome. So, as that starts becoming similar in couples, they start behaving and looking very similar.
Thank you so very much, ma'am.
Thank you, Rashmi ji, for explaining ki thode dino ke baad miya bibi behan bhai lagte hain, lag sakte hain. Yes, I have many other questions, but I have very limited time with us. Yes, there are few questions. See, the problem of insecticides and pesticides. These questions are not mine questions. These are questions I am getting from you too, Wendell. That, see, so much of insecticides and pesticides are used while growing the food material. How to handle this situation, please?
Yes, so that is extremely important, because the use of all of these pesticides, insecticides, are destroying the microbiome of the soil, and that is one of the sources of our own microbiome. So, jo soil ki diversity jo kam ho rahi hai, and we are also ingesting these chemicals. So there are two important factors. The soil diversity is gone and we are ingesting these chemicals. So ye directly hamare microbiome ko affect kar rahe hain. So we need to increase the demand. Unless the demand is there for organic food, for lower use of pesticides and chemicals like this, we are not going to increase the supply. So there has to be pressure, enough demand for this supply to increase. If people start demanding it even more, someday organic food will become much cheaper than normal food. That should be the reality. We are doing a lot of work with GIST in this regard. There's some amazing work which I can talk about later. But ye demand agar hogi to hame uska supply bhi zarur milega.
Yes, many states in the country have started giving emphasis on this organic
yes.
food. Sikkim is 100% organic.
Yes.
Sikkim
yes.
is 100% organic. I can take one more question. डायरेक्टली आपने बात की कूड़े से कैलोरी मिलती है, थोड़ा सा जल्दी से हमें थोड़ा समझाइए कूड़े से
हाँ,
कैसे?
तो मैं उसका उदाहरण मैंने इसलिए दिया क्योंकि जो भी फैट डाइट्स होते हैं दे ओनली टॉक अबाउट कैलोरीज दैट वी शुड हैव दीस मेनी कैलोरीज इन आवर डाइट्स. तो मैंने कूड़े का एग्जाम्पल इसलिए दिया क्योंकि हम कुछ भी अगर बर्न करेंगे, अगर हम प्लास्टिक का पीस भी बर्न करेंगे, लैपटॉप भी बर्न करेंगे, तो उसमें से एनर्जी जनरेट होती है. दैट इज वॉट कैलोरी मीन्स. So are we talking about feeding ourselves with things like this? If we are focus only on calories, it is the nutrients that we need to focus on. जो diets होते हैं वो nutrients के बारे में कभी बात नहीं करते, वो सिर्फ calories पे focus करते हैं. काफी सारे diets, not all. But इसलिए मैंने वो highlight किया है कि even if we burn garbage, we can get calories out of it. That doesn't mean we start putting that in our body.
That's the point.
Yes.
That's the point. Thank you, Dr. Rashmi. And today I like to officially thank my partner in this task, the CSIR, and we are indebted to my colleague who is sitting just beside me, Dr. Anand Mohit, under whose guidance and under whose initiative we could take up this task of doing it. But today I request Dr. Anand Mohit, to whom we are thankful at NCERT, to propose vote of thanks for today's session to Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni, please.
Thank you, Dr. Gupta. We would like to express our sincere gratitude to Professor Sridhar Srivastava, Director NCERT, and Professor Sridevi Anupurna Singh, Director Central Food Technological Research Institute, CFTRI, for the kind support to Prabhas, which paved the way for this national outreach program. We would like to express our heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Rashmi, Dr. Jyoti Lakshmi, and other experts from CFTRI family for planning the program for the benefit of school children and their parents. We would like to thank once again the entire team of NCERT, Dr. Gupta, Man Sunita, and PME Vidya Channel and CIET team for their kind support in organizing this program. Finally, we would like to thank the parents, the audience who were present in this session and in the past sessions, and look forward to joining us next Friday, 10 a.m. for the session on microbiome, environment, nutrition, interactions. Until then, stay safe, eat healthy, stay healthy. Namaskar.
So thank you very much, audience, and for listening us. So we are hopeful to meet you on next Friday at 10 a.m. when we will be having Dr. Rashmi Kulkarni and another team from CFTRI and set of parents. So please keep on asking your questions to us and keep on sending your questions and queries either through our CIET email addresses or through our direct telephone lines, IVRS telephone lines, etc., whatever mode you can. Please do. So hope to meeting you all again on 27th of August. Thank you.